Today I'm going to talk about one of my favourite bits of field hardware, our trusty ruggedised Android tablet by Samsung. A lot of our customers ask us what controllers we pair with our Emlid hardware, and the truth is that it changes from time to time, from job to job. Sometimes we'll want a small portable device that we can stick in our pocket, like my iPhone. But if I'm out in the field all day, usually I'll try to use my Android Samsung Active Tab 3. The benefits that this tablet has is that it's incredibly rugged. I believe it has Gorilla Glass, so it's very tough. It's quite powerful. It's very affordable. They're less than $1,000, somewhere between $600 and $1,000, depending on the specs and where you buy it. It has an external pen, so you can use it with precision, yet at the same time it works with your fingers, and if you modify the settings and the sensitivity of the touchscreen, you can even use it with gloves on. It has an external battery that you can change out at the rear. It's Android, which means that when we're in remote locations, we can still transfer files on and off the device with ease. And as I may have already indicated, it's very powerful. So we can connect to our receiver, we can load up jobs, and if I select a job here that's got a decent amount of data, this job's got 1600 points in it, and you can see it's loading that job and moving around that job very easily. It doesn't have any problems with screen redraw or thinking. It works well with Carlson layout as well, so it's a wonderful platform to pair your Emlid RS2 hardware with Carlson layout. And again, it's quite responsive. One of the challenges, it's rated for 11 hours continuous video playback. However, I find that when we're out in the field with the screen on full brightness, out in the sun, with the Wi-Fi on, the Bluetooth on, communicating with the Reach receiver, bringing the NMEA positioning data into the tablet, that we get probably 5 to 6 hours out of the receiver. So you need to start thinking about alternative power supplies to maintain the charge on your tablet if you're going to put in a full 12-hour day. So you can use an external power supply, like a little USB battery bank, and connect that to feed power into your receiver. Or one of the alternatives is to use a USB OTG cable. So this is a USB-C OTG cable that I can connect into the Emlid receiver and draw down the power supply from the Emlid receiver itself. And using a USB cable, I can then feed that power from the Emlid receiver into the tablet. So that's an alternative power supply to keep things ticking along during the day. The Emlid receivers are rated for 16 hours battery life with everything on. So you can probably tap into that to some extent. I personally haven't been doing that yet. I've been working with the USB power banks. And again, this is a 5000 milliamp power bank, and I'll probably get 4 to 5 hours charge out of that. So that's the wrap, ladies and gentlemen. It's a tough tablet, it's affordable, it's useful, it's compact, it fits in the side pocket of my jeans. Samsung do make a slightly larger one, a 10-inch, this is the 8-inch version. If you want that bigger screen, personally I find its combination of ruggedness, power and portability a perfect match for our Emlid hardware when we're out in the field. Thanks very much for joining us, and we'll see you next time.